Hello everyone, myself Dr. Sunildatta N. Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to deliver a video session on numerical on load factors, that is first video session. In continuation to my previous video sessions, today we are going to see how to find out the various types of load factors from the given data for a power plant. At the end of this session, student will be able to draw the load curve and load duration curve for the given data. Also, students will be able to find load factor, plant capacity factor, plant use factor, and plant utilization factor. Now, in this video session, we are going to solve the problem on various types of load factors. Now, let us see the problem statement. A generation station of 1 megawatt is supplied a region which has the following demand. Here, the installed capacity of generation station is 1 megawatt. Now, demands for particular region are as follows. From midnight to 5 a.m., the demand is 100 kilowatt. From 5 a.m. to 6 p.m., there is no load. From 6 p.m. to 7 p.m., the demand is 800 kilowatt. From 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., it is 900 kilowatt. And from 9 p.m. to midnight, it is 400 kilowatt. This is the given data. Now, it is given that neglect transmission line losses and find the following. First of all, we are going to draw the daily load curve and load duration curve. Also, we are supposed to find out the load factor, the reserve capacity of the plant, plant capacity factor, plant use factor, and plant utilization factor. Now, solution. Now, let us see how we can draw the load curve and load duration curve. Now, firstly, we will see how to plot the load curve from the given data. Now, as we have discussed earlier, this is the given data, that is load supplied by the power station for the particular region. Now, let us see how this load curve can be plotted. So, as we have seen, from midnight to 5 a.m., the load demand was 100 kilowatt. So, from this particular midnight, that is 0 hour, to 5 a.m., the load supplied is 100 kilowatt. So, we have drawn this particular 100 kilowatt, okay, in the order of time it is appearing. Then from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. there is no load. So, we have not plotted any line from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. that is 18 hours. Now, from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. that is for 1 hour, the load was 800 kilowatt. So, here from 18 to 19, as you can see here, the load shown is 800 kilowatt. After that, for 2 hours, that is from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., the load demand has increased from 800 to 900 kilowatt. So, we have drawn this line vertically from 800 to 900, and for 2 hours, we have shown it as a 900 kilowatt. Then again, from 9 p.m. to midnight, the load demand has decreased to 400 kilowatt. So, from 900, we have drawn the line below and we have come to the 400 kilowatt, and from 400 kilowatt is supplied from 9 p.m. to midnight, that is 24 hours or 00 hours in the morning. So, this is how we can plot the load curve. Now, let us see how to plot the load duration curve. For load duration curve, we are going to use the same data, but the difference between load curve and load distribution curve, as we have discussed in our previous video sessions, is that in load distribution curve, we arrange the loads in the magnitude of decreasing order. So, first of all, we will be taking the time from 0 hours to 24 hours as regular timing, no chronological sequence, and for these 24 hours, that is the for daily load curve, we are going to take the loads in decreasing magnitude. For example, here the peak load is 900 kilowatt from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. that is 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. that is 2 hours. So I have plotted first of all from 900 kilowatt for 2 hours, then the next lesser load was 800 kilowatt from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. So for 1 hour I have drawn the horizontal line for 800 kilowatt. So after 900 the load taken was 800, that is decreasing order. After that the load of 400 kilowatt is there from 9 p.m. to midnight. Therefore for 400 kilowatt we have plotted this for the time period it is given, and then the load has fallen down to 100 kilowatt from midnight to 5 a.m. therefore 100 kilowatt is plotted for this particular time period, that is for from 0 hours to 5 a.m. means for around 5 hours. So this is how we have arranged the loads in the decreasing order, and we have obtained the load distribution curve, and there is no load for remaining period, so further period is shown as the without any load. So now I hope we have understood how to plot the load curve and load distribution curve. Now as we have seen that in the problem it is given that neglect transmission line losses. So let us pause the video and think for a while that when we neglect the transmission line losses, what is the power supplied from the power station? So as we can see, whatever power generated will be equal to power transmitted to the load, to the consumer. So power generated will be equal to power transmitted when the transmission line losses are neglected. Now installed capacity, as we have seen earlier, it is equal to 1 megawatt, that is equal to 1000 kilowatt, and maximum load that is equal to maximum demand was 900 kilowatt. The average load we can find by an equation which we have already studied in our previous video session as area under the load curve divided by number of hours. The area under the load curve will be equal to the load in kilowatt multiplied by hour divided by total number of hours for which the load curve is plotted. So from the our earlier data we can find out the average load by an equation, that is average load equal to 100 kilowatt for 5 hours, so 5 into 100 plus for 13 hours there is no load, plus for 1 hour 800 kilowatt, then for 2 hours 900 kilowatt, and for 3 hours it is 400. So 5 into 100 plus 13 into 0 plus 1 into 800 plus 2 into 900 plus 3 into 400 divided by duration for which this load was existing, that is 24 hours. So we get the average load as 4300 kilowatt hour divided by 24, which is equal to 179.16. So this is how we have obtained the average load by using the equation area under the load curve divided by number of hours. Now we can find out the load factor, which is given by the formula average load upon maximum load. Average load is 179.16, whereas the maximum load is 900 kilowatt. So when we put this value, we get the load factor as 0.199, or it is equal to 19.90%. Now let us see how to find out the reserve capacity. The reserve capacity will be equal to installed capacity minus maximum demand. Now we have seen earlier the installed capacity of the power plant was 1000 kilowatt, whereas the maximum demand was 900. So the reserve capacity is obtained as 100 kilowatt. Plant capacity factor is given by average demand divided by installed capacity. Now average demand is nothing but the average load, which is equal to 179.16 divided by installed capacity is 1000 kilowatt. So plant capacity factor comes out to be 0.1791, that is 17.91. Plant use factor will be equal to actual energy produced in kilowatt hour divided by plant capacity into number of operating hours. Now as we can see that the actual energy produced we have calculated is 4300 divided by capacity, installed capacity is 1000, and plant is operation only for 11 hours. For remaining 13 hours, there was no load. So we get the plant use factor as 0.3909, which comes out to be 39.09%. And plant utilization factor is given by maximum demand upon installed capacity. Maximum demand was 900 kilowatt, installed capacity 1000. So we get plant utilization factor as 0.9 or 90%. These are the references. Thank you.